Mr. Sprinkle?
Thank you. Good evening to everybody.
Good evening.
On page two of the morning paper was this article, "School Board Aims for Transparency." It's been an issue that I've been concerned with for many years. I know I was here once before speaking on an issue like that, and sort of feel it must have fell on deaf ears. But I'm glad to see it come now, because consent agenda, which appears at this board, is only approved as what it's been in the past. But that is when the board gets to spend your dollars. It's all discussed at the committee meetings. They have two committee meetings, but the buildings, ground, finance, I believe, spends the most of it. And unless you attend that meeting, which is not recorded, you do not know anything about how their money is spent. And it comes here as a consent agenda item and is then spent. And I am really happy to see that that is now coming before the board. I'm hoping this paper article is wrong when it explains how there was some concern about how long the meeting would be. Because you took the office when you ran for it, and you have to do the job, or maybe find somebody else that wants to. But I think it's great that you're going to go and be transparent and let the people know how you're spending their money. I know you've advertised, you've campaigned on, we do it for the children. Well, the parents pay the bills for the children. And I appreciate you all bringing that up. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, moving on in our agenda. We need to approve the agenda. Are there any modifications to it? Anything needed to be added? Or do you know anything that would be anyone else?
So moved, Madam Chair.
Have a motion to approve the agenda. Do I have a second?
Second.
It's been moved and second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. The agenda's been approved. You've had an opportunity to look over the minutes from January 15th. I'd like to entertain a motion to approve those minutes.
So moved.
Barbara, thank you.
Second.
Any discussion on the minutes? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The next thing up is the report of the standing committees. We have two standing committees, and we're here for report first from the Building, Grounds, and Finance Committee, and I believe Mr. Williams is going to be making that report.
Sure. Ms. Pete is our chairman, but I happen to have the report here. And I'll kind of run through this fairly quickly. We met on the 12th with all our members present. The items that we heard that day, there were five items on the agenda that are on the agenda for tonight. So I won't go through those because you'll hear those under action later tonight. Then there were a few items that we heard, I would call it more of an FYI. Our executive director, Mr. Obley, presented a request for the board representative to serve on a energy management committee, and I believe we'll hear more about that later from probably our chairman, who will make that appointment. Mm-hmm. But that'll be something for the chairman to follow up on. We heard another report from concerning child nutrition balances, and you may have already seen this. There's been a couple of reports on that, where we have made some improvement of over $2,000. We still have a negative balance of $9,854. We also got an update from Mr. Obley on the north side tile project that's proceeding. No problems there. We also heard a request from Eastern Elementary to put murals on the wall. Our recommendation was to go back to them, and we would agree to put murals on the wall on a frame and mount them to the wall, but not to paint murals on the wall, on the blocks. So that's our recommendation for them to go back and discuss that. There's three items that would need to have a motion, so I'll cover those now. Once again, Mr. Obley presented information concerning Southside High School, a transformer insurance claim from back in 2011, where we received a check reimbursement of $45,959.95, if you want to know the cents. And he requested that that money from the claim be put back into the maintenance budget. And the reason for that, that's where the money originally came from. So this is just to put that back. And the Building and Grounds recommends approval for this item because, as I said, the money came from there, so the check should go back there. But I believe I would need a motion from this board to have that.
You can make a motion from the committee.
I can make that in your hand. Okay, well, the committee recommends that we approve that, so I make a motion that we approve that.
Okay, we have a motion to approve that, to move the $45,959.95 back into the maintenance budget. It requires no second since it is coming from the committee. Any discussion on that? Okay, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay.
Okay, Mr. Obley also presented a request from Southside High School to begin a garden project at the school. And as that was explained to us and a layout was presented, it was a small area that would be put on the outside perimeter of the school grounds, maintained by Southside students. And if at any point in time they decide not to have the garden, it would be up to them to clean it up. That's the way we instructed them to handle that. So once again, the committee would recommend that we approve that motion for them, so I make that motion now that we do so.
Okay, the motion's on the floor to approve the Southside High School's request about the garden plot. Any discussion on that?
Madam Chair, point of clarification, do all members vote or just the committee members?
Right, all members will be voting. No questions or anything on that? Okay, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, motion carries.
Okay, and the last item coming out of Building and Grounds was concerning Easton Elementary School Playground Project, which basically the project means they need to replace a slide on the playground. Mr. Obley is going to follow up on that and make sure everything is handled proper. And the funds are provided by the PTA. So once again, we suggested that, yes, we approve that since we don't really have to pay for it. So coming out of the committee, I've put the motion that we approve the plan and let Mr. Obley follow it.
Okay. Any questions or concerns regarding that discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, motion carries.
And that completes the report. As I said, the only other items are on your agenda tonight, so we'll cover them as action items here.
Thank you, Mr. Rear. Okay, from Personnel and Curriculum Committee, a report will be given by Ms. Banks.
Thank you, Madam Chair. The Personnel and Curriculum Committee met on February 7, 2013 with all members present. Testing Coordinator Andrea Lilly distributed to the committee a spreadsheet that outlined the 2012-2013 testing irregularities and misadministrations. County Athletic Director Joe Koch presented information concerning the number of coaches per sport. The committee asked Mr. Koch to gather information concerning how many volunteer coaches would want reimbursement for taking the required training by NCHSAA. This information will be presented at the next Personnel and Curriculum Committee meeting. Finance Director Steve Toler presented budget amendments for approval. These amendments will be presented at the Board of Education meeting on tonight's meeting for approval. And I believe he also spoke with the Building and Grounds Committee. Superintendent Don Phipps presented Policy 8000 series for review. Our next Personnel and Curriculum Committee meeting is going to be on March the 7th, 2013, 4:30 in this boardroom conference room. And then finally, Child Nutrition Director Gwen Robertson McBride presented information concerning the NC Child Nutrition Procurement Alliance. She recommended to the committee that we join this alliance, and the committee voted to support the NC Child Nutrition Procurement Alliance. And at this time, I would like to make a motion to support this recommendation from the committee.
Okay. The motion's been brought forward from the committee. It doesn't require a second. Is there any discussion about the allowance motion? No questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, motion carries. Thank you. Moving on to the discussion, no action. The first item is the Policy 8000 series, and Dr. Phipps.
We have the, that policy is in your board packet, if you'll notice, behind tab number one. And as we've gone through this, there are a couple things I want to highlight and ask you to take a look at. So if you flip back to tab number one in your packet, you'll see the 8000 series policies are there. They're in sequential numerical order. And wanted to highlight just a couple. If you'll go to 8210, policy 8210, this deals with grants and funding for special projects. And again, as we've talked about this before, the School Board Association, as they go through and do their policy revisions, are trying to take into account what they have in a template or boilerplate, and then also what we've had in place. And as we've read through this, there are some things that we want to make sure that we are either match our current practice, or if there are issues that we need to change for state laws and whatnot, we want to do that. But the line that's in the second paragraph that says all proposals will be presented for board approval, our practice is that all proposals of $1,000 or more will be presented to the board for approval. We have a number of different teacher type grants that are below $1,000 that would hamstring you all if we brought everything through here. And we do look at those to make sure that they're consistent with our mission and vision, but we don't want to say all proposals, but anything that will be $1,000 or greater. And we'll make that correction and bring that back to you as we do our second meeting. Any questions about that? Moving forward, if you'll go to policy 8350, this is a fixed assets inventory. The second paragraph under section A says definition of fixed assets, and here it says that they're both real and personal property, the end of that first line, having a value of $500 or more. Our practice is if they're $5,000 or more, so we're going to make that change. And that's the practice that we've been following. As you can see, they're also with an estimated useful life of 2 or more years.
What's the reason for the, such a difference?
That's just what they have in their policy, but it's not the practice that we normally follow.
Yeah, okay.
Patrick, did I hit everything that we've talked about? And there are a list of, as you go through these policies, you're going to see that there are a lot of to-do type things that need to be done, reports that need to be made. What I'd like to do is for us to get on a schedule, and I don't know if it'll be a monthly schedule, something different each month, but I'd like for us to be able to anticipate 12 months in advance the types of reports and information that you all need to get so that you're not overwhelmed with things in the end of July or some other month, and we can start to do this and make sure that we're following up. For instance, what is our list of insurance that we have, and do we have additional insurance needs? Those are required by policy to be reported out to you all, and some other practices that we need to follow. But as we go through each of these policies, we want to make sure that we're doing what we say we're supposed to be doing and that we're following our own policies in terms of standard operating procedure. So I put those before you today. We'll bring these back again next month for second reading. And if you have any other corrections, if you'll let me know, we'll get that to the board members.
Has anyone else noticed anything else they'd like to address with that? I had one on 8230 under penalties, fines, and forfeitures. The last line reads that the superintendent shall report periodically to the board. I'd like to be more specific there, maybe put quarterly. Was kind of what I was thinking.
I've got a to-do comment on there, and I want to make sure that we do that. We've not had as many of those with the economy the way that it's been, so that's starting to pick up, but we'll come to you with a quarterly report and let you know what that looks like.
Okay. All right. Anyone else?
Yeah, I see.
Okay. E-Board Solutions, Dr. Phipps.
E-Board Solutions is a tool that exists that would allow us to go paperless in our meetings. It would allow us to put our books together, but they'd be done not in a tangible format, but electronically. It would also allow board members, the employees of our school district, and the public to be able to go online and access all the documents associated with the board meeting or any board action. We had a presentation on that and just wanted to ask for feedback. I want to let you all know that we're working on calculating our cost and time and hours so that you have some idea of what savings would be involved there, if there are any. We're also looking at other products and costs. I'm aware of at least two other products that are out there, and we want to shop and compare a little bit about the value and what types of services are there. But I think the real value and the real product that we're going to see as a result is just the ease of access. And again, I think that would be for you all, as well as the general public and any of our employees that would need to go through and pull out any pertinent information related to board activity and action. So we're not asking for any action today. You all have had the presentation. I didn't know if you had any feedback, and we'll come back to you with the additional information once we have that.
I think it's long overdue that we need to go ahead and address it as soon as we get all that information. We got too many school systems around us that's already ahead of us, and a lot of them are smaller than we are.
And I like that you're going to get some other prices and look at some other companies. The only thing that I say bothered, it didn't really bother me, but concerned me a little bit, was there were only 14 counties out of how many, 100 in North Carolina? And the question I meant to ask, and I don't know that he could have given us the answer, was how many counties in North Carolina are actually using some sort of e-board system? Is 14 out of 50 counties, or is it 14 out of 90 counties? If so, then what are the other 70-some counties doing that might be less expensive or might be more efficient? So, but you answered that in that you're looking at other ones. But that would be my question. How many are already doing this, and what system are they using? Because 14 wouldn't really a lot.
I think there's more than that. It might be not using that same.
Just using something different. That's what I'm thinking.
That's right.
Be nice to know what they're using and all. But, I mean, it was a good presentation, but it is kind of expensive. No matter how you look at it, it's an expensive project.
Okay. Any other comments on that? Okay. Can I get a motion to go into closed session?
You can. I move that we go into closed session pursuant to General Statutes 143-318-11 to prevent disclosure of confidential personnel files under General Statutes 115C-321 and 143-318-A1 to prevent disclosure of confidential student files under 115C-402.
Okay. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? All right. Go into closed session.